Now, when it comes to spending big on a pair of designer shoes or an on-trend bag, look at me, swiping the credit card can sometimes get the best of us.
I'll do this. It can't be that bad. It's just like a Band-Aid. It's gonna be fine. Bex! $200 on Marc Jacobs underwear. Oh, underwear is a basic human right. $78 on lavender honey. I felt sorry for the shop assistant. She had a lazy eye. I didn't know which way she was looking. She was looking at me. It was so sad. I can't even talk about this one. A foot spa. What were you doing at a foot spa?
Let's take a break.
They said I was a valued customer. Now they send me hate mail.
While The Confessions of a Shopaholic is a rom-com focusing the lens on the shopping addict, the reality is far from comedy.
Yeah, Nikki Hobson racked up $50,000 worth of debt across 10 credit cards. But one dress is all it took to pay it off. Nikki Hobson joins us now with Bernadette Oliver, co-founder of The Volte, to tell us more. Nikki and Bernadette, welcome to the show. Nikki, first, what made you turn to renting out your clothing?
So at the time, I was working really hard to pay off a large personal debt, which meant that my budget didn't allow for any non-essential spending. And as someone with a lot of events and a real love for fashion, this was really tricky for me. So I think my boyfriend was just really sick of hearing me complaining about having nothing to wear. So it was actually his idea to invest in a designer outfit, listed on the Volte, and then see if it could pay itself off.
Oh, great. So Nikki, what was the piece that started it all? And how fast did you wipe your debt?
So this little shirt and short set here, it was purchased back in 2019. It's since been all over Australia. It's been to hen's parties and birthdays. and it's been worn and loved by many women across Australia.
Oh, if that dress could talk, hey?
Hey. Has it had a better social life than me?
Hey, Bernadette, you're a co-founder of The Volte. How did the idea come about?
Well, being lovers of designer fashion, myself and my co-founders hated our dresses sitting in our wardrobe barely worn. And with the rise of the sharing economy like Airbnb, we thought, why can't this model be applied to your designer wardrobe? And we really saw the circular fashion economy as the answer for the fashion industry to become sustainable.
Well, have you seen a shift in consumer behaviour now, especially since lockdown?
Well, I think dress rentals have really crossed over to mainstream. I think borrowers love having their fashion on demand and experimenting with beautiful designer looks. We're seeing feathers and really fun outfits after lockdown. And lenders love earning from their closet as well as offsetting their carbon footprint.
Nikki, I was talking to my wife last night about this and she loves the idea, like Tristan's wife. They go to many events and obviously look to save money. But what we want to know is, do you wear all the clothes you rent out, or do you have two sort of separate wardrobes with yours and the rented ones?
Look, I try to wear every piece, but I now have more outfits than I do events.
Okay. Oh, great. Have you ever had a situation where you may have rented something out and it didn't come back the way you rented it out?
Look, I've been really lucky over all of my hires. I have never really had many issues. Everyone is really respectful of the clothing. I have had one incident recently where a dress has been sort of lost in the post, and the Volte has been there to sort of liaise between myself and the renter to resolve that dispute.
Great. And just one real quick one, sorry. In terms of cost, I mean, that was a big debt you had. So I mean, how much is a typical dress? Does it depend on the designer name?
Depends on the designer name. So with my $50,000 credit card debt, I was able to pay that off in under 18 months by largely offsetting a lot of my personal expenses. By listing my outfits on the Volte, it gave me that ability to then focus on really, you know, paying my debt down.
And one final one, we just got a viewer question here from S.Harris. Oh, actually, no, Sarah H. She wants to know, can you try before you rent? Can she just try it on Monday?
You can.
You can.
You can. I do in-person try-ons for anyone that's Brisbane-based. Postal try-ons are a little bit more tricky. It just takes the dress offline, and but it's definitely something you're welcome to message me about, and we can chat.
How good.
If anyone needs a Brett Wilson suit, give us a shout after the weekend.
Yeah.
Ladies, thanks so much for joining us today. Great idea.
Good job,
and congratulations.
Girls.
Well done.
Thank you.